Hi students, today I am discussing about the topic is stem. Stem means it is the aerial or ascending part of the plant. Aerial part or ascending part. Ascending part of the plant, and it develops from the plumule. At the time of seed germination, the seed produces two structures. They are radicle and plumule. Radicle grow into the soil and they develop into root. And the plumule grow above the soil and they develop into shoot or stem. Hence, it develops from the plumule of the embryo. Plumule of the embryo of a germinating seed. Germinating seed. Next, young stems are green in color, but matured stems are brown in color, dark brown. Young stems are green in color due to the presence of chlorophyll pigments, but matured stems are brown in color, dark brown. Next, each stem consists of nodes and internodes. Each stem consists of nodes and internodes. At the place of the nodes, leaves are born or leaves are developed. Leaves are born at the place of the nodes, and the portion between the two nodes is called internode. This is the node region, and this one is another node. The portion between the two nodes is called internode. And at the place of the nodes, leaves are developed or born. Next, it also consists of terminal bud and axillary bud. Terminal and axillary buds develops on the stem. Next, the upper angle between the stem and the leaf is called axil. This is the axil. The upper angle between the stem and the leaf is called axil, and axil bears a bud is called axillary bud. And axillary bud, which in turn develops into lateral branches. The lateral branches develops from the axillary bud. Next, and at the top of the stem, it also contains a bud. It is also called as apical bud or terminal bud. Next, function. Functions of the stem. It spread out branches. Spread out branches, leaves, flowers, fruits, etc. And it also conducts water, minerals and photosynthesis or food materials. Stem involves the conduction of water and minerals and food material or photosynthesis. This is the main function of the stem. Next, stem modifications. Very important 8 marks question. How stem is variously modified to perform different functions? That means stem modifications. A permanent change. The permanent change that occurs in the shape and structure of the stem and modified to perform special functions related to environment is called stem modification, a permanent change that occurs in the shape and structure of the stem and modified to perform special functions related to environment is called stem modifications. The stem modifications are three types. First one, underground stem modifications. Second one, aerial stem modifications. And third one, subaerial stem modifications. And the first one is underground stem modifications. Generally, the stems are present above the soil, but in some plants, stems present under the soil or below the soil. Hence, these type of stems are called as underground stems. The underground stems involves storage of food material. They involves storage of food material in the underground part, and also involves organs of pollinations. Organs of pollination to tide over conditions. Unfavorable for growth. This is the second function. And also protected from grazing animals. Grazing animals like goat, sheep, cow, buffalo, due to the presence of stems in underground part, the plant parts are protected from the grazing animals, and also involves the vegetative reproduction. All the underground stem modifications involves vegetative reproduction. That means newly developed plants are developed from any vegetative part of the plant. The vegetative parts in the plant are root, stem and leaves. Hence all these are involved in vegetative reproduction. These are the underground stems. The underground stem modifications are four types. First one is rhizome. It grows horizontally beneath the soil. The underground stem that grows horizontally beneath the soil is called rhizome. Example, ginger. And turmeric. Curcuma, longa. These are the examples of rhizome. This is the diagram of rhizome. And second one is corm. It grows vertically. The underground part of the plant that grows vertically inside the soil. This type of underground stem modification is called corm. Example, Amorphophallus, Jamingkund. Amorphophallus, that means Jamingkund and Colocasia. These are the examples of corm. This is the diagram of corm. Next, third one, stem tuber. The terminal part of the stem that stores food material and become tuberous. Hence, these are called stem tubers. Example, potato. Solanum tuberosum. Potato. And it also consists of eyes. Eyes generally involves in vegetative reproduction. Next, fourth one, bulb. In onion, Allium sepa onion. The stem is reduced to form a discoid structure, and below the stem, adventitious roots are developed, and above the stem, this is the stem. The stem is reduced to form a discoid structure, and below the stem, adventitious roots are developed, and above the stem, leaf bases store food material and become fleshy. These are called bulbs, and all these are the underground stem modifications. And second type of stem modifications are aerial stem modifications. Aerial stem modifications are 5 types. First one, stem tendrils. Tendrils are long. The tendrils are long, slender, that means weak, and spirally coiled structures. Long, slender, spirally coiled structures are called as tendrils. And these are developed from axillary bud. They may be developed from axillary bud or terminal bud. And tendrils are used for climbing purpose. These are useful for climbing purpose, and they develop from axillary bud in gourds like cucumber, pumpkins, and watermelon. These are the examples of stem tendrils that develops from axillary bud. And terminal bud in grapevines. These are the stem tendrils. Tendrils are long, slender, and spirally coiled structures, and these are useful for climbing purpose, and they develop from axillary bud in cucumber, pumpkins, and watermelon, and terminal bud in grapevines. This is the diagram of stem tendrils. This is the tendril. And second type of aerial stem modifications are thorns. Thorns are hard and woody pointed structures or needle-like structures that develops from axillary bud in bougainvillea and the terminal bud in citrus and Carissa, Carissa carandus. And these thorns are useful for protection purpose. These are the thorns. Thorns are hard, woody, straight, pointed structures, and that develops from the axillary bud in bougainvillea and terminal bud in citrus and Carissa. And these are useful for protection purpose. This is the diagram of tarn. Next, third type of stem modifications are phyllocase. Phyllocase means in plants which grown in desert areas or dry regions, the leaves are modified into spines. Leaves are modified into spines to reduce the rate of transpiration, and stems are modified to fleshy flattened in open shear. Fleshy flattened in open shear and fleshy cylindrical in euphorbia. Fleshy cylindrical in euphorbia and needle like in casuarina. These are the examples of phyllocase, the plants which grown in desert areas or dry regions. Leaves are modified to spines to reduce the rate of transpiration, and stems are modified to fleshy flattened in open shear, fleshy cylindrical in euphorbia, and needle like in casuarina. This is the diagram of phyllocase. Example, open shear. Next, fourth one, cladophylls. Cladophylls means limited growth branches that are modified to perform photosynthesis. Limited growth branches that are modified to perform photosynthesis. These type of modifications are called cladophylls. Example, asparagus. And last one, bulbils. In agave and diaspora, the vegetative bud in diaspora and floral bud in agave that stores food material and become tuberous. These are called bulbils. If these bulbils, they separate from the parent plant, they produce adventitious roots and they develop into a new individual plant. Hence, they are involved in vegetative reproduction. Only bulbil that involves in vegetative reproduction in aerial stem modifications. And the third type of stem modifications are subaerial stem modifications. Subaerial stem modification means half of the stem is present below the side and half of the stem is present above the side. Such type of stems are called as subaerial stems. The subaerial stems are four types. First one, runners. Second one, stolons. Third one, suckers. And fourth one, half sets. And first one is runners. In some grasses, strawberry and oxalis, the stem spread into new niches. When older parts die, they develop into a new individual plant. Such type of stems are called as runners. in some plants like grasses, strawberry and oxalis. Stem spread into new niches when older parts die. They grow into a new individual plant, such type of stem modifications are called as runners. And second one, stolons. In nerium, jasmine, in nerium and jasmine, a slender means weak, a slender lateral branch that develops from the main axis of the stem or main axis of the body, and these branches grow aerially for some time and obliquely downwards to touch the soil and produces adventitious roots and develops into a new individual plant. Such type of plants or such type of stems are called as stolons. Examples: nerium, jasmine and rose. And third one, suckers. In banana, chrysanthemum and pineapple, underground stem produces a lateral branch. These branches grow horizontally beneath the soil for some time and obliquely grow upward and produces leafy shoots. These type of stems are called as suckers. Plants like banana, this is the underground stem. The underground stem produces a lateral branch. These branches grow horizontally beneath the soil for some time and obliquely grow upward and produces a leafy shoots. Such type of stems are called as suckers. And last, fourth one, half sets. In pistia and icarnia, the stem is reduced to form a discoid structure, and above the stem rosette manner of leaves are developed, and below the stem tuft of balancing roots are developed. This is the stem. The stem is reduced to form a discoid structure, and above the stem a rosette manner of leaves are developed, and below the stem tuft of balancing roots are developed. Due to the presence of balancing roots, these plants are freely float on the water surface. Next, axils of the leaf produces a one internodal lateral branch. These one internodal lateral branch is called half set. And all these underground stem subaerial stem modifications involves in vegetative reproduction.